Welcome to Oxford Academy's very first live virtual talent show. I'm Tyler Mitchell.
And I'm Abdullah Sahi.
And we're your MCs for today's show. But before we can get started, a couple of thanks are in line to a couple of very important individuals. Isn't that right, Abdullah?
I think that's very right, Tyler. First off, how could we forget the people behind today's show? Oxford Academy, ASB Senate, whoop whoop! That's right. They've been working tirelessly these past few months to bring the show to you virtually, which is hard to do,
I would say.
That's right. Today would not have been possible without their tireless commitment to serving the students, so thank you for that.
Next up, we would like to give a very, very special thanks to the Senate advisor herself, Mrs. Hale. Your passion, love, commitment, and drive are simply endless. And for that, shout out to you, Mrs. Hale.
That's right, Tyler. And lastly, how could we not extend our gratitude? How could we not forget the tireless, the countless hours of heart and soul that have been poured into...
What was that? I was getting ready to leave. Soul behind.
No, we don't. Can I take it?
Yeah.
Thank you. The tireless hours of heart and Tyler.
Sorry.
And soul that have been put into these acts by the performers today. So no matter the outcome of today's show, you guys are all winners in our hearts.
And on that note, let me have my moment.
Sorry.
And on that note, let's get on with the show.
Oh my God, man, help! Dude, these are taking so long. I'm so tired.
This should not have taken an hour to get one
take. What was with all this, man? It was throwing me off.
Listen, I thought that a little extra flair would have enhanced the show.
It would have... You know what? Okay, speaking of flair, check out this TikTok thing. Right? Look at that.
It's all right.
Look at the comment. What do you mean all right? Look at the comment. He's like, great job. So funny. Look at that. He said he's dying from laughter. Poor guy's dying. What do you mean, all right? You get 5 likes max. This is 1,000 likes.
Listen, all I'm going to say is that the algorithm is rigged to one person at this table.
What?
They don't want to give underground creators like myself
the platform. Oh, you're underground now.
Yes, I am underground.
Okay.
I'm just an unknown talent on the street
right now. Yeah.
Okay? So all I'm going to say is that my content is there.
Uh-huh.
The algorithm's afraid to show it.
Dude, you know what? I'm sick of this arguing back and forth and sick of this talent show hosting whatnot. I'm just gonna watch some TikToks, maybe make some of my own, and prove to you that I'm better. Because that's the truth. That's honestly the truth. Look at that.
I know you are not making a competition out of
it. I am making a competition. Bet! Bet!
Bet!
Get off of me.
Get off of me.
Shut up. I'm watching the TikToks.
Abdullah?
Yeah.
The camera 2 is still rolling.
I can see the red light, man. I'm not stopping.
Attitude of yours is exactly why your content is just not there yet.
You can't say that on live television. Well, back to the show. Alrighty, folks.
No, they know that we're just not two constant bundles of energy that are here to entertain people 24/7, put schoolwork on the back burner, just dress up in a Paul the Patriot costume, and just go out into the quad and dance for everybody, doing the Macarena and such. You know, sometimes it gets a little hard having to take this job, constantly being in front of people. They always ask, what do you offer? But how are you going to change the world? You know, they never look at you as the individual, but as the main act. And it's honestly a little infuriating at times.
Well, I'm sure they want to see what we've been up to, so I guess let's just move on to the show and show them who's capping, because I bet they're curious.
All right, let's roll the TikToks, I guess.
Ayo, the juice is loose! OJ?
No, silly Snapple!
Tyler, what are you doing? What are you watching?
Oh yeah, I've been channel surfing. I'm looking for this thing my friend told me about, but I can't find it.
And what are you looking for?
Two pretty best friends.
Do you notice me? Do you notice me? Yeah. I just wanna know, shawty, do you notice me? Shawty, you should roll.
Can you guys hear me? Hey, let me know if you guys can hear me. Can you hear me?
Hey, now, lady. Yeah. If you know you bad. Yeah. Don't need no man. Got your own bands. Put up your hand. If you're a top-notch, let me holler. Bend it over. Touch your toe. Whip it out.
slangy how you.
Hey man, watch where you going.
Oh my bad, kid. I was just on you.
Dude, you see what I mean, man? My videos are better, and they've got more likes. It's just, it's clear, man. I don't know what else there is to say. I'm getting more likes.
No. You and I both know that the algorithm is rigged. We agreed on this when we thought we were off air, okay? All I'm gonna say is that we leave this to the people at home to decide.
Hello, I am the people at home, and I think a good TikTok has good lighting and is something eye-catching.
No, wrong people at home. The other clip of the people at home, please and thank you.
If I were to choose between Tyler and Abdullah, I would choose Abdullah because I think his videos were funnier.
I don't know what you're saying, but Tyler's was obviously better.
Yeah, I agree with Brian. Tyler's so much better at TikToking.
Oh my gosh, this is like so good. This is gonna be really hard. I can't choose. I'm undecided.
Well, looks like that was a tie. I mean, that was so anticlimactic for no reason. Right, Abdullah?
You know, I'm okay with it because I'm just glad we were to put aside our differences and actually have a conversation. Because so many times people just want to talk, but no one actually wants to listen. And that's where the key to fixing this problem is. Because right now, as a society and as a nation, we're so split on everything. And no one wants to actually have these conversations and find a solution to bring us closer together. Everyone's right here or right here, but no one wants to try to meet in the middle and actually find a solution to these problems. Anyways, back to the show. Nicki Minaj! That's right, folks. Celine Lee and Suman Kim will be kicking off the show with, you guessed it, Nicki Minaj!
My name is Celine.
And my name is Suman. And we are sophomores at Oxford Academy, and our group name is
Opfer!
Which means sacrifice in German, meaning that we'll sacrifice everything for you guys to make a great entertainment source.
Alright, so today we'll be performing Super Bass by our one and only queen, Nicki Onika Mirage, and she has always been our number one role model, so we will be performing one of her most hit songs.
We applied to this talent show to make great memories, not because of the prize, not because of the money, because life isn't all about the
money, it's not about the money, we just wanna let the world know all about our talent.
So vote for us, everyone! We will be watching you!
Yeah!
On deck like he's saving up, and he might got a deal. He pop bottles and he got the right kind of bill. He cold, he dope, he might suck a coke. He always in the air but he never fly coach. Your mother loving trip trip, sailor of the ship, when he make a drip, kiss him on the lip. Look, that's the kind of dude I was looking for. And yes, you'll get slapped if you're looking, oh, excuse me, you're a well of a guy. I mean, my, you're like pelican fly. I mean, you're so shy and I'm loving your tie. You're like sicker than the guy with the thing on his eye. Oh, yes I did. Somebody please tell him who he is. I am Nicki Minaj, I pack them dupes up, back coops up and check the look up.
For us! really got my heartbeat running away, if you know what I mean.
I know.
Nice vocals, ladies.
Yeah, I totally agree with you, Abdullah. I didn't think it was possible to make an acoustic version to any Nicki Minaj song.
Yeah.
So, thanks for proving me wrong, Suman and Celine.
Well, after all that boom, 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 boom bass, I think it's time that we take a, you know, well-deserved stretch break, a little bit of cool down.
Yeah, that's a great idea.
And if you're at home and you want to get up, maybe stretch a little bit, maybe work those muscles a little bit, feel free to join us.
Yeah.
Ooh.
Oh my goodness gracious.
Tiring hours. Dude, I'm glad I got off to those dress pants.
Yeah,
imagine.
I know. These shorts are just so comfortable. I can't imagine life without them. Check this out. I was doing this over the weekend, right?
Yeah.
Let's see. Check this out.
Oh, the full touch! Full touch! Ooh, did the camera get that? Ooh, that was nice!
You got that?
Nice!
You got that? Of course, more time.
I was just trying to do the.
I was, you know, I was talking to the boss about getting more space between
here. Look how cramped we are!
They said it was that or the second camera. And, you know,
I really like that.
Yeah. Well. That was a very much needed stretch break. Wouldn't you say so?
I think very much so.
I hope you were able to join us at home. Well, anyways, did you see me touch my fingertips while I was back?
That was nice.
Incredible. I haven't done that since seventh grade, by the way.
So,
with that, arguably the most flexible person on campus.
What?
Not the most.
No, don't disrespect the goats like that, my guy. The goats!
Oh, the goats!
How
did
you forget?
Oh my god,
I don't
know if I
put the
goats. Don't do that
again.
I'm so sorry. I did not mean to do that.
Happening.
Okay. Well, do you
want
to see some flexibility? Do you want to see two monsters on the mats? Two beasts of the beams? Two masters of the rings? What's the word I'm looking for?
Ringmaster?
Yeah, what he said. Yeah.
Sorry.
Yeah. Dude, ringmaster.
Ringmaster.
Anyways, look no further. Because I have what I just described. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, I present to you Ashley and Christine Young.
Hi, I'm Ashley and I'm a junior.
Hi, I'm Kristen and I'm an eighth grade.
You don't need a helmet.
Oh, I thought you were driving.
No,
I'm driving.
Oh my god.
A helmet!
For the talent show, we're going to be doing, what are we doing?
Gymnastics. We're also gonna be doing
gymnastics. What's the next question? Hold on, I need my microphone. Back with the microphone. What does winning the talent show mean to you? Winning the talent show would mean you practice a lot, like a lot. And so if we could win, then that would be super duper cool.
Yeah.
Bye.
Dude, that was some pure talent, man. I'm gonna give you a shot after seeing that. Yeah. You know what? Actually, wait. Why don't I just do a cover right now? Check this out. Mm-hmm. Just, can I do it? Mm-hmm. Oh, what are you doing? Oh, what are you playing?
Oh, I'm sorry. I just found this new game. I downloaded it recently.
Yeah.
It's pretty underground. I don't blame you if you've never heard of it. It's called Among Us.
Oh, yeah. I think I've heard of it. Yeah. Can I play?
Yeah, just a second. I have to do my card swipe in attic.
Wow. Are you good? What? Just that?
Oh my god. Okay, so basically the way the game works, there's imposters and crewmates. So the imposter, right? The name is Uyu.
Yeah.
Uyu came into where I was, admin.
Yeah.
While I was doing my card swipe, attacked me while I had no chance.
What?
Okay.
Yeah.
Hopped in the vent, because there's vents that connect the entire ship.
Yeah.
Got away. Somebody walked in and saw Uyu vent. Right, reported my attacking, took it to the emergency meeting, basically told the entire crew that I got attacked and that Uyu did it.
So what I'm getting at is that Uyu took your breath away.
Stop! Now is not the time to be making jokes. A crime was just committed in my cartoon game, okay? I just got attacked by a being with no arms, okay? I'm just laying there in administration, okay? And this person gets to commit more crimes in this cartoon ship, right? The members of this cartoon ship, who are also cartoons, don't know that basically there's a cartoon imposter among them, hence the name Among Us, okay? You're just gonna make a joke out of it? Ooh, they took my breath away. No! Somebody needs to hold these people accountable. And all I'm gonna say...
I was trying to segue into the next thing. We have a group, a dance group at Oxford named Uyu, and they're the next act. I was trying to segue into that. The next thing, man. Why would you do that?
Oh, my bad, player. See, that's just what happens when you're a real boss. You get real passionate about the things you do. You know, the games you play. It's okay. I lost it.
You're good.
Hey, Abdullah, do you know who totally isn't an imposter and really took my breath away with it?
Just for a sec.
My apologies. My bad. Ladies and gentlemen, give it up for our next group. Uyu!
Take it away, girls.
We're Uyu,
and we're all seniors at Oxford Academy. I'm Pauline.
I'm Maddie.
I'm Karina.
I'm Grace.
I'm Jennifer.
And we'll be performing Pop Stars by KDA and Wannabe by ITZY.
We all have a really big passion for performing, and we've really been missing dancing together during quarantine, so we wanted to apply so that we can all dance together at our last talent show.
While placing may be an amazing accomplishment, it's not really on our agenda because we just really love performing and we want to put our passion on display for everyone to see.
Thank you.
Let's get it, show you up. Can you feel the rush now?
For the longest time, I thought that I was a really good dancer, but after watching OUYU, I might have to freshen up on my skills a little bit.
Dude, yeah, honestly, come on, that was amazing. What are they, like, graduating this year?
This year?
Dude, yeah, time flies, crazy. But we have to see OUYU in the months to come, because that was, like, beyond talented.
Definitely.
Yeah.
I guess you can say that it was OUYU amazing.
What the? Moving along.
No,
anyway,
stop. Mother, are you baking some of your world-famous store-bought banana bread again?
Tyler, enough. We're the only ones here. Stop, dude. Stop that.
Oh, my sincerest apologies. Oh,
enough with the accent, too. What's that about?
I just want to have more fun with that.
Can we focus?
Yeah, I guess. People. Sorry, I thought that my mom was making her famous world famous. Famous
what?
Or world famous?
What?
I don't know. All I know is that it's pretty famous. It was
okay.
Her world famous store-bought banana bread.
Yeah.
Basically, the fruity aroma and just the spongy taste on the tip of your tongue make you reminisce on years past.
Tyler, the fruity aroma, it's that smell of corn syrup from Walmart, and the spongy taste is because the bread is spoiled, man. It's expired. You gotta get that thing checked. Dude, that's not a problem. You know what? You gotta take your baking skills up a notch, my home slice.
Number one, never hit me in the chest again. That kind of hurt. Number two, please never ever disrespect my mother's world-famous store-bought banana bread. A lot of hard work goes into picking only the freshest of pre-packaged loaves. Okay.
You want to talk about working hard? Working hard? People come from around the world to taste my mother's sweet, sweet love. Sweet, or as you would say, love that is put into her banana bread, man. Don't even talk about that.
Listen, I may confuse the aroma of banana bread and high fructose corn syrup up a lot.
How could you?
But, all I know is that I know when I can smell a challenge.
Okay, fine. You know what? Cue the baking montage. Welcome back. This is the Tyler and Abdullah Baking Show, where we actually don't do any baking. We just eat the food and show you guys.
Yes, sir. Real mukbang style. Now, for today's challenge, as you might have been able to see in the baking montage, today we have banana bread. More specifically, banana nut bread. So all of my people with nut allergies, this one does not include you.
Look away.
Look away right now, please. We don't want to give you any allergy flares or anything.
Yeah,
yeah, no. We don't know the science behind that yet. So, how this is going to work. We have Abdullah's banana nut bread on the left and my banana nut bread on the right.
Store-bought.
Let me emphasize that. Spongy taste, fruity aroma, the whole nine yards. So, one of us is going to be blindfolded and the other is going to be feeding the other. Now, don't worry. We've washed our hands. Very safe. Okay? This is a controlled environment. Okay? Look at it. You can't see the germs on my hands. So, we're going to taste, right?
Yes.
We're gonna analyze it.
Yes.
And when it's over, we are going to basically pick the winner.
Yes.
For each of us.
Yes.
Okay.
Okay.
So first up, Abdullah, go ahead and put on your blindfold.
Thank you. Don't do anything weird.
So once again, we have Abdullah's on the right. I'm so sorry, that's mine on the right. That's Tyler's on the right.
Feed me the food.
And Abdullah's on the left. Okay. Here is loaf number one.
We'll call him.
Making a mess in my studio.
So what do you think? How does it taste?
Spongy.
Spongy? Fruity?
Not really fruity. It's really warm, and it kind of sticks to the top of my mouth in a good way.
Yeah, in a good way. I get that.
Okay.
Are you All right. ready for taste test, too?
Oh, wait. I feel like some crumbs.
Yeah. Go ahead and clear your palate. Here is bread number two.
Was that your finger?
That might have been my finger, but we're not going to talk about that. Now, what are you feeling?
Definitely less warm, but I don't know if that's...
less warm.
Oh, this sticks to my mouth, but in less of a good way. Mm. But there's definitely a nice kick. It's definitely nuttier.
Nuttier. Wow. That's very, very, very good thing, right?
Can I get another bite, please, of the second one?
Yes, you can. Tilt your head back. Okay, I got it. We're good. All right.
Actually, this is pretty good acting. Not gonna lie.
Very nutty. Sticks to the roof of the mouth.
To be honest, are we gonna give our results at the end or?
We can save it for the end.
Okay. I think I've got my answer.
Okay. I guess it's my turn to eat some banana nut bread.
Okay.
Yeah, go ahead. Big juicy bites from Abdullah. Now it's Tyler Mitchell's turn.
You good?
Yeah, I'm ready.
Here we go. You good?
I'm ready.
So first up, we're gonna be giving Tyler his own.
Oh yeah, thanks, buddy.
Just a joke. You ready?
I think so.
I don't know. Big bite. So. Oh, that was a big one. Nice. How does that feel? How are you feeling right now? That was a nice big bite. Make sure to chew. You don't want to swallow that.
I just inhale mine.
Initial thoughts?
It's very banana-y.
I mean, you would assume so with banana bread.
Yeah. No, it's very good. It tastes very fresh and authentic. Uh-huh. Kind of like my mom's.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
Interesting.
Mm-hmm. Oh, I can taste a chunk of banana.
Oh, that's good. Yeah.
Very good. Yeah. I can tell this was locally sourced.
Locally sourced, yeah.
Very fresh ingredients from around our community.
Yeah, made with love.
Yeah.
Nice. You good? You ready for the next one?
You're still eating. Okay, gotcha.
All
right, let's roll the second one.
Okay, let's go. Oops. This one's kind of crumbly.
Oh. It falls apart.
Did you get any?
I did not. All I felt was a loaf of bread fall on my mouth. All right, I'm going to tilt my head back. Just drop it in. All right?
Okay.
So I guess what we've learned from this, not very safe, not very sanitary to be giving each other banana bread.
Thoughts?
This one is actually very good, but not as fresh as the first one.
Really?
The first one was really just like out there.
Yeah.
You can taste the quality. This one, not gonna say very salty, but
there's salt?
A kick of salt.
Really?
Small kick at the end. I don't know, maybe it was the handler's hand.
My hand. What? You didn't get a bite in my hand, you got a bite in the bread.
That's what they all say. I'm just gonna say that to you. I don't know, I can't see the camera. I think I'm looking at it. Okay, yeah, very cool. Very delicious.
You good?
Yeah.
Do you want to make another bite or are you good?
No, I think I got my answer.
You ready? All
right. So, I know my answer. Dula knows his. On the count of three, we're gonna share.
The
it's
number?
Either gonna be one, two, or tie.
Okay.
Okay. On three, not on go.
Okay.
On three. One. Two. Three. Tie.
Oh. Tie.
Whoa, is it a tie?
No, I thought you said go. You said we're gonna go on go. So all right,
we're gonna redo this. One.
Two.
Three.
Go!
Die.
You said go on go!
Okay. We're gonna go on go this time. Okay. One.
Two.
Three.
Go!
Tie!
Oh my god, what are the odds? Oh,
I did not see that one coming out of Abdullah Fatah.
I know, what are the odds? Let's hear it from Tyler Abdullah. Thank you, guys. Tyler Abdullah, thank you. That was amazing. You know what I've been thinking? I think we're shoelaces, my guy.
What?
Yeah, because, you know, all we do is tie.
Dulab. I can always count on you to say the most out of character things.
You know, speaking of
I said don't hit me.
Speaking of counting on someone, here to perform Count On Me by Bruno Mars is Vivi Tran and Letty Scow.
Take it away, girls.
Hi, I'm Letty Scow. I'm in ninth grade.
And I'm Vivi Tran. I'm also a ninth grader.
And Vivi and I are performing Count On Me by Bruno Mars. Vivi's on the ukulele and I'm singing along. We just kind of saw the email that was sent out and thought that it sounded like fun. So, like a fun thing to do, I think. So we chose a song and applied. Looking back at it, I think it was also a nice distraction.
Writing to us would kind of be like an expanding point, or could possibly be an expanding point to do something bigger out of like this hobby that we just have.
If you ever find yourself stuck in the middle of the sea, I'll sail the world to find you. If you ever find yourself lost in the dark and you can't see,
one on an instrument and one with their voice, singing in the moonlight. Just the thought of it, really, I feel a sense of unity at the thought of it. I love the moonlight. Cue the moonlight. Cue the moonlight. Cue the moonlight. Oh, I'm sorry. I'm not. You're the amateur. You don't have actual moves. We couldn't hire. Oh, yeah, I know. Budget.
You good?
I think we're good.
I'm good.
I'm good. I'm hot. I'm ready. I'm good. 5, 6, 7, 8.
In the year 2020, Corona hit us, and then we had to quarantine, and it kinda sucked, with a stay at home here and a wear a mask there. CDC and FDA approved a whole bunch of PPE and ventilators to save lives and actually help us. Shout out to the first responders out there who are saving lives. We love you. But we also made TikToks and baked banana bread.
What just happened?
Oh my god.
I think we just made a banger.
I think so. Pop. Oh my gosh. Top 100.
I feel ya, brother. Wow. I feel ya.
The power of song really just does something. You know?
Amen. But, I think that we can both agree that there is nothing more powerful than a well-played piano song. Isn't that right?
100%. Let's hear it from piano legend, Kirtana Venkat.
Kirtana Venkat, and I'm a senior here at Oxford Academy. I've never actually performed or auditioned for the talent show, but I decided to this year since it's my last year here and I wanted to make the best of it. I will be performing a piano cover of the Interstellar theme. I love Interstellar and think that it's an amazingly made movie. In this cover, I recorded two separate tracks as I felt that the song would better be covered through two tracks and not one. I'm really glad I applied for the talent show as I know it will give me more confidence to share my art with others. I really hope you guys enjoy my performance. Thank you.
God. And so I'm just brought tears to my eyes. You see him. Cortana, that was great job. That was beautiful. I think I'm gonna need a moment.
Dizzy.
Here you go. We just have some on set by chance. Here you take this. Oh my God. Good? Oh my God. That was beautiful.
Cortana, beautiful. Beautiful. Tyler, speaking of toilet paper, actually.
You good? Are you good?
Good.
You know, it actually really makes me cry. Remember back. Remember back when, what's it called, we had COVID when first started, everyone was going crazy over that toilet paper thing? What was that all about?
I do remember.
Okay, so what I want you to do is pretend this is some valuable toilet paper, okay? Some Karen at Costco is trying to take this toilet paper from you, okay?
Please, I win every match against a Karen.
Okay, right. Okay, good to know. So I want you to focus on this really bad, okay? So you're just gonna follow this and make sure you see, you're gonna follow my hand as if it's a toilet paper, okay? Follow it really well, okay? I want you to focus really hard here to see where the toilet paper is gonna go, okay? Ready? 1, 2, 3. Which hand has the toilet paper?
This one.
What?
Tyler!
Dog.
Okay, one more chance. I'll give you one more chance. Ready? 1, 2, 3.
This one.
Oh my God! Okay. It's right.
Cut the cameras. Cut the cameras.
Focus. I really want you to focus on this one. Okay. Ready? 1, 2, 3. Which one is it?
This one.
What?
No.
Oh my God! What? Right? Dog, look behind you.
Oh!
How did you get there?
You saw that, right? You saw that. I made the guess. I focused on the hand.
Tyler, if you thought that was amazing, just wait till you see our next one.
It's gonna blow you out of the water.
Nah.
Tyler. After that, that's the only thing that's ever fooled me.
Trust
me. Please. I never get fooled. Not that easily.
Tyler, hear me out. Our next guest, David Lee, magician, is gonna blow your mind with his amazing magic. You know what? What do we say?
Please, have you ever seen me get fooled on camera? I don't think so.
Tyler, what? I'm trying to segue again. Can you stop? David Lee, take it away.
Hey everyone, my name is David Lee, and I'm a junior at the school, and this is my first time performing at Oxford's talent show. And the act I will be performing for you today is a little bit of card magic. It's a take on the Omnideck trick, but because of the circumstances we're in right now, it had to be modified so it could work for the camera, I guess. And I decided to apply for the talent show because I was asked very nicely by members of the Senate, and with the kindness of my heart, I decided to apply. Yeah. And winning the talent show, what would it mean to me? It would be a means to boost my ego and cure my crippling low self-esteem. Thanks, guys. I hope you enjoy my act.
Hi, guys. Welcome to David's Magic Show. I'm your magician, David, and I'm coming here today with two members of the virtual audience. Would you guys like to introduce yourselves?
I'm Mason. I am a junior this year. Very glad to be here right now.
I'm Donna. I am also a junior this year, and I am excited.
Okay, thank you, Mason and Donna. So before I begin, I just want to clarify for the audience that you guys don't know anything about this trick. You haven't discussed it beforehand or anything?
No.
No, okay, perfect. So I'm just going to pan down here, right? I have a deck of cards, and this is with Matt. I'm just going to spread through, right? And as I riffle through the deck, I want Mason to just say stop whenever she feels like it. Remember, there's a little bit of lag, so say stop earlier than you would normally do in real life.
Stop.
Right there?
Can you go a little more up?
A little more up, like there?
Yeah.
Right there, okay.
Yes.
Their card is the King of Clovers. Donna, why don't you give me something to write on clovers to mark the card? It could be anything. Something simple, initial, or a little.
Can you draw a little happy face?
A little happy face.
Yes.
That's a little happy face.
Beautiful.
And everyone see the little happy face? I don't know.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, we got it.
Cool. So I'm just going to put your card into the middle of the deck. Right? And let's try something. I'm going to place the cards under my hand, and I'm going to try to pull your card out of the middle of it. Well, that's not exactly your card, but it's a joker, and jokers are a wild card. So, yes, I win. Now, that's kind of cheap, right?
Ha 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 ha. Funny. Great trick. Whoa, yes, great trick.
Let's try something different, okay? What if I made every single card in the deck disappear except for the card that was selected, right?
Our real card?
Yeah, and if you just check that. And if you check, all the cards in the deck have disappeared except for your card. Right? All the cards disappeared except for your card with your little smiley face in it. Wow.
Whoa!
What? Wait. What?
What's that thing? The chunk.
Can we see the side of it? Because I couldn't tell. Like, when did you switch the deck out? Or, like, where'd the deck go? Did it just, like...
It disappeared, Donna. They all turned into glass.
Like... I'm defying all laws of physics right now. It just disappeared.
Another trick.
Okay. I have a spread deck of cards.
That was so strange.
I'm gonna move my finger across the deck like this, and this time, Donna, you can just say stomp on it.
Okay. Stop.
Right there? This card?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. And this time, Mason, give me something to write or draw on the two of spades.
Draw a sad face that is also angry. Yes.
Sad face that is also angry.
Oh my gosh, wait, turn it upside down.
Yes.
This is so cute.
Perfect. Okay. So, I'm gonna leave your card at top, right? As the sad, angry face on it, right?
Yes.
You can see there too, the two of spades. I'm just gonna push it in, right?
What?
No.
What?
Bye.
What?
Hey.
Hey guys, thank you for watching my performance. Stay safe, and I hope you enjoy the rest of the show. Thank you.
Tyler, why don't you tell me that you'd be joined by some guests? That was amazing.
Honestly, because I'm not a part of the act. Yeah, but anyways, I'm just really glad that Donna and Mason were able to join David on stage.
What did you say? I know, right? That was amazing, but I just have no idea how he did that trick with like the clock. Did he just carry that around his back pocket everywhere he goes? That was amazing, though.
Perhaps. I mean, a real magician never reveals his secrets.
But, I mean, David, if you want to drop a little hint, do a little nibbit in the comments below that. I mean, why not? You could help us out.
Well, while we're talking about magic, I think our next members are sure to give the audience a little bit of chemistry in the air.
The line's magic because we just had a magic act, and then like the joke is that it's magic and then it leads on to the next one. Gotta get better with the segues.
Okay.
Yeah.
Well, while we're talking about chemistry, I think our audience will feel a little bit of magic in the air with our next performers. Give it up for our next and last performers. Gracie Soto.
Okay.
Layla Santos. End of sentence.
Hi, I'm Layla.
Hi, I'm Gracie.
And we're both seniors this year.
And we decided to apply to Talent Show because we thought it would be something fun to do together in our last year of high school.
And in regards to placing, it doesn't matter if we place, and if we do, then we'll be super glad. But at the end of it, like, we're just really glad that we got to experience it together in our last year. So, yeah.
Looks like you could. Why are you laughing?
The Heather of the school.
What do you mean? I could be the Heather of the school.
A little bit dramatic.
I could be the Heather of the school.
You cannot be the Heather of the school because you are the Abdullah of the school.
Yeah, I felt like I was listening to Angels, ladies. Great job.
That was great. Agreed, Tyler. But I can't believe I'm about to say this, but I think that's all we have for the show today. Besides our beautiful talent, but that's for another show.
No way. I was having so much fun watching each of these acts perform for us.
Me too. But I think I know what all the audience members are waiting for. Who are the winners of today's challenge?
Well, without further ado, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, the winner of the 2020 Oxford Academy Virtual Talent Show live is, drumroll please, just kidding, gonna be announced after these commercial messages. We'll catch you. We're not commercial messages. It's not going to be announced because it is not our decision.
Democracy.
Not the worst. Well, we hate to break it to you guys, but we are not going to be picking the winners. That will be the decision of the people.
That's right. You you can check the link down below right here. Should be so. It's somewhere there.
Magic. Now we're editing. You know what I mean?
And you can vote for the act that you think should bring home a lot of moolah. It's a big cash prize.
The cheddar. Thank you. Remember, do not just vote for your bestie.
I'm his bestie.
He's my bestie. Make sure you vote for the act that ran away with your heart. I had like 8 acts run away with my heart, so I mean, I'm pretty torn.
That's right, Tyler. Voting closes in just a few days, so make sure to bring in your vote. If you're in line, they can't kick you out.
That's a different discussion.
As soon as it does, we will bring the results to you.
Well, that's it for our show tonight. Once again, we would like to thank the Senate, Mrs. Hale, the performers, and last but not least, you guys, the audience members at home, for taking time out of your busy schedule to come and join me and Abdullah at this table as we commentate the talent show. We love you guys.
That's right. Thank you all for watching, and I think that's all we have for the evening. Bye, folks.